heard of the Premiere Pro Manager bugs? Do you need to reduce by half the size of your Premiere Pro project? PlumePack is the solution for you. Welcome to this tutorial on PlumePack, the best plugin for Premiere Pro that optimizes project management. It helps you minimize, organize, archive, and transfer your media without losing quality and metadata. This tutorial will guide you through the different options available in the PlumePack process to streamline your workflow and save time. You will also learn what free features PlumePack offers you. We will show you how to download, install, license and use PlumePack, starting from the media process section, where you can determine what will happen to your media file, then explaining the filter and transform steps, where you can choose what to include or discard in the output folder and how your project file will be organized and transformed in the output folder. And at the end of the video, you will see the Toolbox tab and all its precious independent tools. This video will cover a lot of different parts of the PlumePack plugin. Don't hesitate to jump directly to the section you are interested in. Just go to the description of the video and click on section there. At the end of this video, you will become a real Premiere project ninja. Learn how to unlock the power of PlumePack, say goodbye to the ordinary Premiere project manager and send the perfect project to your coworkers. Let's get started. With PlumePack, you can collect all your footage, music, After Effects compositions, and more into a given folder and remove unused media or part of media to save space. PlumePack helps you manage your media more efficiently, doing the same job as the native project manager, but with more features and fewer bugs. With PlumePack, you can trim your file without re-encoding, which saves you space and time. For example, let's imagine you have 1 TB of video data to transfer, but only 100 GB of data is actually used because you are not using the whole part of your video files. You will save a lot of time to transfer and manipulate those files, and it will be easier to find available space for it. Finally, as a fully featured project manager, PlumePack has a toolbox part, which gives the user more powerful tools to change and adapt their project. For example, unmerging merge clip, a Premiere Pro feature which can't be natively reversed, but also more tools that we will see later on this video. To get PlumePack, visit PlumePack page on aescripts website. Click on the Try button and select the right installer for your OS. This will download a zip file to your computer. Unzip the file and double-click on the executable file to install PlumePack. Once PlumePack is installed on your computer, open Premiere Pro, click on Window, then select Extension, and finally, PlumePack Panel. You can access the free version of PlumePack without a license. With this free version, you can use the equivalent of the Project Manager Collect and Copy feature. To learn what PlumePack Premium can do for your project, start an analysis and click on Trimming Enabled Analysis. This will tell you which files could be trimmed and how much space you could save by using trimming. To unlock PlumePack Premium features, you will need a Premium license. To get this license, you have to come back to aescripts website, select Premium License in the options, and click on Add to Cart. After the transaction, you will receive a license key in your email. To license PlumePack, click on Settings and License at the bottom of the PlumePack panel, copy and paste your license key, and click on Activate License, and then OK. If the change has not been taken into account, click on Reload panel at the bottom of the panel. With PlumePack Premium, you can use our main feature, trimming your file without re-encoding. When you work with a lot of media, especially heavy file, you want to remove parts of the file that you won't use in your project. Unlike the Project Manager, where all your media are re-encoded into a new codec with the Consolidate and Transcode feature, PlumePack copies a part of the file, removing unused frame, but preserves the same codec quality and metadata. First, this can be particularly useful for people working with RAW codec, such as Blackmagic RAW, Red RAW, or ProRes RAW, because you want to stay with the same codecs and keep the power of the source settings of your files. We are using the official SDKs from Blackmagic Design and Red for RAW and Red RAW. so that you can get the exact same files as if you used their official tools. Trimming is also useful for other kinds of video files to reduce disk space and usage, which is especially useful for transferring or archiving projects. For now, let's see the PlumePack options. It's important to note that you won't lose any files during the PlumePack process. PlumePack creates a new project and safely copies or trims your media to a new location, all without modifying your original project and media. There are three main processes in PlumePack: media process, filter, and transform. So we will also separate the option between these three processes. The first media process section determines what will happen to your media: trimmed, only copied, or not processed, with more specific options depending on your needs. The second, filter steps, answers the question what will be included or discarded in the output project. Finally, the third step in PlumePack answers the question, how will my project file be organized and transformed in the output folder? This step is all about data structure and allows you to specify how your output file will be named and organized. It lets you reorganize your project and file in the output folder. When you change an option, the information is saved and will be reloaded the next time you open the PlumePack panel. You can learn more about any option by clicking on it or going to the documentation tab to read the explanation. Let's now detail the media process PlumePack setting. If you choose only copy, you will have to choose a copy mode. If you check keep the same number of files, it will copy your files only once, even if it's used multiple times in your project. But if you choose each timeline clip into a unique file, the file will be copied as many times as it is used on timelines. For instance, here the file is used 3 times. It will be copied 3 times. This copy mode can be useful if you want to export each clip into a single file, so it's easier to send separated clips to different persons, like different colorists or different VFX professionals. One last thing to note, you can choose to include proxies or not, depending on your needs. Then, you have more control on what you want to do with proxies. You can copy only proxies, copy proxies and main media if there's no proxies attached, or both main media and proxies. With the media process trim mode, you can also choose between different trim modes. The first trim mode is called Minimize Disk Space. This mode will trim any unused part of the media files in your project. It is the best mode if you want to optimize your project and it should save more disk space than the other modes. The second mode is called Keep the same number of files. It will guarantee you won't have more output file than input file. It is less optimized than the first option because if you use the beginning of a file and the end in your editing, the center part will be kept even if unused, to only generate one output file. And the third mode is called each timeline clip into a unique file. It is similar to the copy mode option, but each timeline clips will be trimmed independently and will generate a trimmed file. Let's illustrate the difference between minimized disk space and each timeline clips into a unique file. Here, you can see the file is used 3 times and there is an overlap between 2 timeline clips. With each timeline clips into a unique file, 3 trim files will be generated. In comparison, with minimized disk space, only 2 files will be generated to optimize the space saved. The next settings is the ability to choose the handles, to add more frames than the one used, in case you want some freedom to refine your edit later. The last media process mode is called No Process. This mode is useful if you want to clean your project without moving media files. Media will not be copied or trimmed. Now let's move to the second step of the PlumePack process, which is the filter part. The filter section allows you to specify which media files and project items you want to include or exclude from the PlumePack process. The first option, Remove Unused Item, is important because it decides if you want to filter or not at all. If not, all unused items in your project will stay inside. If you use Trim as main media process, trimming will still be enabled on media used across sequences. But if a clip is not used at all, it will be copied entirely. Another important setting is keep only chosen sequence and depth. With it, you can select a sequence in your project to be the main sequence considered by PlumePack. So everything used in that sequence, with also the nested sequence and the nested sequence inside the nested sequences, and so on, will be kept in the new project. Other sequences or items not used in the main sequence will not be part of the new project. If you want to select multiple main sequences, a workaround for now is to create a new sequence, which will be the selected main sequence, and then add all sequences you want to be part of the final project in this sequence. The third and final step of the PlumePack process is the transform section. In this section, you can specify how you want PlumePack to transform your project data structure and file names after the PlumePack process is completed. For example, you can choose to rename your media files using their project item name, or reorganize your project and file structure on disk using the different data disk structure option. With Premiere Pro bin structure, your final media structure will correspond to your bin structure inside Premiere Pro, so the same structure you see in the project panel here. With original folder structure on disk, your media structure will be the same than your original disk structure, following an intelligent automatic algorithm to determine which main folder will be used. And with flat data structure, your final media structure will be as flat as possible. Every copied or trim file will be placed in the same folder. Note also the really useful parameter to avoid filename duplication. So even if they are placed in different folders, all filename will be different. This parameter can be useful to prevent bad relinking in the future. With PlumePack Analysis, you can have access to a lot of information on your project and preview what will happen. Let's try here to launch the analysis with the main sequence selected and original folder structure on disk as data structure mode. At the end of the analysis, I can preview all the sequences that will be part of the PlumePack project and the ones that will be removed. With a premium license, you have the ability to access the given sequence directly from there. You can also preview the final data structure here to make sure it works for you. And that's it for the overview of the PlumePack process. Now, let's take a look at some of the other features of PlumePack. As I mentioned earlier, PlumePack comes with a special tab called Toolbox. This tab provides access to a set of independent scripts that can perform various special actions. For example, you can use the Trim Selected Clips to trim only some given timeline clips instead of launching the trimming process on your whole project or on a whole sequence. Another really interesting tool you can use on this tab is the Unmerge Merge Clip. It is something Premiere Pro does not allow you to do, but with this tool, you can select Merge Clip and revert the merge. Last but not least, we have added a tool to reorder your sequence tracks. This tool will not only move your tracks, but also audio effects and track associated keyframes. Finally, I'd like to remind you that PlumePack is available in two versions, the free version and the premium version. The free versions provide access to the basic PlumePack features such as only copy feature. The premium version, on the other hand, provides access to all the advanced features of PlumePack, such as the trimming feature, the toolbox tab, and more. To get the premium version of PlumePack, you need to purchase a license on our website. Once you have a license, you can easily activate it in the PlumePack panel and start using all the premium features. If you have specific needs, features, or new codec to support, please contact us at autochroma.com. And that's it for this video tutorial. I hope you found it useful. If you have any question or feedback, please feel free to leave them in the comments below. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.